I've told you a bit about information. Bits, labels, probabilities. I is equal to minus the sum over I p sub I log to the base 2 of p sub I, the fundamental theory, a fundamental formula of information theory. I told you about mutual information, which is if I have two variables, such as the input and output to a channel. The mutual information tells you the is equal to the amount of information that's shared in common between input and output. It's the information that passes through or gets through the channel. And in fact, from Claude Shannon, it's actually equal to the practical channel capacity. Or if I pick the input probabilities or frequencies that maximize the mutual information, that mutual information is the rate at which information can be sent reliably down this channel. You cannot send information at a higher rate, and you can send information at that rate. This is a tremendously practical application of information theory, because it tells us if we have noisy channels or lossy channels, channels where we're using sound, channels if we're using light, channels if we're using electromagnetic radiation, channels where we send information through the mail. Any such channel has a capacity, and Shannon's theorem tells us what that capacity is. It tells us that we can't surpass it, and it tells us how to achieve it. And this is at the basis of the application of information theory to practical communications, for instance, via fiber optic cables. So there are some fun examples of this. So a nice way to look at this picture is that here we have this channel. We have x in, we have p of x sub I. Here we have the output. We have p of y sub j, y out, given x sub I in. And then we have the associated mutual informations. So here we have I x. This is the information in. Here we have I y. This is the information that comes out. The information that goes through the channel like this is the mutual information between the input and the output. We can also look at some things that I'm going to call loss, and another thing that I'm going to call noise. So what is loss? Loss is information that goes into the channel, but it doesn't come out, like the roaches going into a roach motel. So what is that? It's information that we don't know about the input, given that we know the output. So if we know the output, this is residual stuff that went in, bits that went in that never came out. Similarly, the noise is information that came out that didn't go in. So noise is stuff where if we know exactly what went in, it's residual bits of information that came out that had no explanation in terms of what went in. So we have a nice picture in terms of the whole set of processes that are going on in information. We have the information going in, we have the information going out. We have the loss, which is information that we have the loss, which is information that goes in that doesn't come out. We have noise, which is information that came from nowhere that didn't go in. Of course, it actually comes from physical processes. And finally, we have the mutual information, which is the information that actually goes through the channel and that represents the channel capacity. So I also talked a bit about computation. So if you have a digital computer, here is what digital computers looked like when I was a kid. You had like a tape thing, you had a bunch of little lights on front and switches, you know, and then you'd read the tape and then it spewed out some input maybe on some paper tape. You could even put some input on paper tape. It would have some memory like this. All digital computer is doing is breaks up information into bits, which are the smallest chunks of information, typically called 0 and 1, or true and false, in a digital computer, and then flips those bits in a systematic fashion. So for all their power and all their stupidity, all of these digital computers that we have, including things like our smartphones, as well as our desktops and supercomputers, all they're doing is registering and storing information as bits, and then flipping those bits in a systematic fashion. And let me just remind you of this fundamental theorem about computation, which is that any digital computation can be written in some kind of circuit diagram. Here's X, here's Y, here's Z. Here's something where I make a copy of X. I take a OR gate, this is OR, you recall. Here's a copy of X, here's X here. This is X OR Y, also known as X OR Y. And here I can say, for example, take an AND gate, and I can here send this through a NOT gate. And then I can combine them in another AND gate. And in the end, I think that what I have is NOT X AND Z AND X OR Y. So when I have a digital computer, what happens is it takes bits of information, it performs simple AND, OR, NOT, and copy operations, and by doing these sequentially, in whatever order you want it to do it, you end up evaluating arbitrary logical expressions, not X and Z and X or Y, whatever that means. I have no idea what it means. Well, it is what it is. It means what it is. So if we talk about digital computation, all digital computers are is taking information and processing it. And if we put together computation and communication and probabilities, what we find is that taking together the idea of information, processing information as computation, sending information reliably from one place to another is communication. This information refers at bottom to the probabilities of events, being sunny, being rainy, probability that a photon going into a channel makes it out the other side, probability of zero, probability of one, probability of heads, probability of tails. But when we put together these three pieces interlocking, what we get is the theory of information. And I hope that in the course of these brief lectures here, I've been able to convince you that these remarkable processes that are going on all around us, the fault or result of the information processing revolution that began in the mid-20th century and continues at an accelerating rate till this day, can be understood with a simple set of mathematical ideas that are interlinked with each other and give a set of ideas of very profound richness and impact on human society with implications for I don't know what. Thank you for your attention. Do well on the homework. Exam will be multiple choice. I'm sure you will all do well.